Well, we've got two teams fighting to stay in the race here in the Big Ten West. And for Northwestern today, a shot at bowl eligibility. As we welcome you to Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, sold out for the 346th game in a row, honoring one of Tom Osborne's national championship teams here today, and excited about a new coach and a new era. You're watching College Football presented by 5-Hour Energy. I'm Beth Mullins along with Anthony Becht here at Memorial Stadium. What to watch for today? Well, Anthony, how are the Huskers moving forward after those four heartbreaking losses?
Well, they're trying to get off the last play of the games and look at bigger picture and try to win the first three quarters so they don't put themselves in that situation.
We're also watching the evolution of Tommy Armstrong at quarterback under this new system.
You're right, he's coming off his best game last week against Minnesota outside the pocket where he's been most dangerous throwing the football.
And for Northwestern, can the Wildcats return to the run game that served them so well when they started out 5-0?
You got to feed the ball to Justin Jackson. He is the key. Get the big uglies pushing off the line of scrimmage and get him involved early in this football game.
Nebraska trying to go back-to-back for the first time this year with a couple of wins off the victory against Minnesota. And for Pat Fitzgerald and Northwestern, a couple of rough losses. They got beat up pretty good by Michigan and Iowa, so they want to try and get back on track. Of course, the former All-America linebacker and Hall of Famer at Northwestern, now in his 10th season. Opportunity to get back to a bowl game for the first time since 2012 if they can pick up the win here to get to 6 on the season. Nebraska has won the coin toss. They have deferred, so Northwestern will go back to receive. For Nebraska, they've been so good here at home over the years, but they've already dropped a couple of games here at home and have started out 3-4. Each of these teams is 1-2 in the Big Ten, and they are looking up at Iowa, undefeated right now. So really, not much of an opportunity for a team that drops down to a 1-3 to get back into the West race. For the Huskers under their first year head coach, Mike Riley, so successful at Oregon State before coming here to Lincoln. They were booted away. Solomon Vault and Miles Schuler back deep. Vault has a kick return touchdown this year, 98-yarder in their win against Duke. And a good return for Vault. An opportunity with a blocker in front of him as he gets across midfield and shoved out of bounds around the Nebraska 40, but there is a flag down back at the 30-yard line. As it stands right now, a 60-yard return for Vault. Jerry McGinn, our referee today.
Third and return, holding. Return team, number 8. A 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First and 10.
And so that 60-yard return will not stand. It's going to come back. There's a tug on the jersey right there. So a good effort by Vaughn negated. And Clayton Forson and the offense will be out there to start at their own 14-yard line, the redshirt freshman, the first-year starter. And play action on first down. Thorson will keep. And he'll get to the 15, and that's it, wrapped up there. They really like his steady demeanor and his competitiveness, and he's looking to get a little help from his skill guys today.
Well, they're preaching balance. You can't lean on a redshirt freshman to do everything for you. I thought they were heavy pass last week. They got to get the running game involved, and he needs to use his legs against this Nebraska defense.
And here's a touch for Justin Jackson, a 1,000-yard rusher as a freshman a year ago. Not much going on against a Nebraska run defense that is top 10 in the country, pass defense that is dead last statistically in FBS.
And you look at this team going against Nebraska, this suits them well as far as the defense for a team that's trying to ground and pound.
Got an injured player down on the deck here for Nebraska. It's Jack Gangwish. And this, unfortunately for Husker faithful, has been a common occurrence with the injuries on the defensive side of the ball. They've had 13 different guys miss games. They've had 20 different defensive starters out there for new coordinator Mark Banker. They are also without one of their DBs, Jonathan Rose, missing from the game today due to an off-field issue. Daniel Davey is getting the start. He's just returning from injury as Gangwish gets back up. He's 95. Had a shoe pop off there at the tail end of the place. He kind of rolled over onto the runner, Jackson. Well, the crowd will crank it up a bit here on third and eight. Thorson gets the pass away and it's incomplete. Out to the 25-yard line. Vitale unable to hang on. And Northwestern will have to boot it away. They've got a terrific kicking game. Hunter Nicewander. And then one of the top return guys in the country for Nebraska in DeMorne Pearson L, who was returning from injury and is getting back to full strength.
One thing you tell the punter, don't kick it in the middle of the field against this guy.
High kick, and Pearson L with the fair catch. Good field position to start out here for the Huskers, just a 37-yard punt. And that'll bring out Tommy Armstrong in the offense, the junior from Texas. Already top three all-time at Nebraska in passing touchdown, passing yardage, total offense.
It's been a big transition for this young man. You're talking about new verbiage, a different style offense. They've only put in about 50% of what Oregon State used to do when Mike Riley was there. The biggest thing is they've tried to build around what he does best. He moves around the pocket. He's become a better passer. That's the biggest thing he's done the last couple weeks.
He's throwing more and running less than he did a year ago, and they'll come right out with a designed run for him in the high snap. And Dean Lowry was able to sniff it out, the senior out of Rockford, Illinois. Let's check out the impact players when the Huskers have the football. And Terrell Newby will carry a lot of the load for them in the backfield.
Coming off his best game last week against Minnesota Westerkamp, folks. This kid catches everything. Anthony Walker will be challenged in the middle for Northwestern, especially when you have a quarterback that moves around like Armstrong.
Newby is offset on second down. Armstrong fires, and the completion to DeMorne Pearson L, making his second start of the season, coming back from that offseason foot injury.
Yeah, you're right. You know, getting off to a slow start in the last couple of weeks, trying to slowly bring him back into the offense. And we see him being an explosive player in the punt return game. He's becoming that in the real wide receiver game also.
Monty Cross now in at I-back. Andy Janovich has been an emerging threat at the fullback spot here on third and short. Cross will follow behind his fullback, and he's got the first down inside the 40. And a 6-yard run.
Old school fullbacks. I love seeing them go up the gut. Watch him right here. ISO 101. Boom! Hit him in the face, knock him back. That's what the tradition's been here at Nebraska. The big uglies, the guys that don't get recognition. Janovich is one of those guys.
He took care of Jalen Prater to clear the space for Cross. Janovich will stay in there now as Newby returns. They fake to the motion man. Newby down inside the 35. Let's check in with Paul Carcaterra.
Anthony, you mentioned the new offense for Tommy Armstrong. He had his best game of the season from a quarterback rating standpoint last week against Minnesota. He told me his focus lately has been his footwork and staying in the pocket, allowing to get him to his second and third reads, critical in Mike Riley's offense.
You're right, Paul. They use that footwork drills every day in practice. It's continuing to get better with him, but they want him to see the field better. They love his running ability, but they feel like they can beat teams in the pass, and they're leaving yards out on the field.
On second and five, to the air again. And the catch around the 26-yard line. Alonzo Moore, the junior out of Winfield, Louisiana.
You talk about the wide receiver core and what these guys did. Tommy Armstrong brings so many things. Big arm, strong. You see him in the pocket, but his receivers have done a great job catching the football. And right here, most dangerous, the thing that Northwestern doesn't want, him rolling to the right. They got to force him to his left, where he's been less effective as a player.
Another injury for Nebraska. Alonzo Moore, the guy that made that catch, and he'll trot off to the sideline. Armstrong, through it all, has shown an affinity to throw the deep ball. They have 16 completions of over 25 yards on the season, and they've got some playmakers, especially with the return of Pearson L, who will go wide left. He's ISO'd to the top of your screen up against Keith Watkins. Making just his second start. He run to the left and down to about the 25-yard line. Anthony Walker, their leading tackler, the middle backer, making the stop.
They love Anthony Walker, got great coverage skills, contact, loves to hit, leads the team in tackles with 54. I think he's going to have his hands full today as one of those guys to watch that has to follow the quarterback throughout this football game.
And Anthony, they were able to stop the run when they started out 5-0, and then Michigan and Iowa ran all over them in their last two losses. Certainly on the radar for Armstrong and Newby and company. Armstrong looking deep down the middle and tipped incomplete. Jalen Prater got a hand on it, and it's 3rd and 10.
Again, you see a little bit of him in the pocket there, trying to get to his second read, come across the field. And, you know, those are the things he's trying to improve on as a quarterback. He's not truly going to be that pro-style drop-back guy like a Sean Mannion was at Oregon State. They got to kind of build around what they're trying to do. And, you know, Mike Riley really loves working with him. He loves that feature of a running quarterback also.
Getting our first look to it, Jordan Westerkamp now, who is in at wide receiver. He's been their leading receiver. He's slotted to the left. Eighth play of this drive, looking for a third down conversion. They try and set up the screen to Newby, and it falls incomplete, and it's fourth down.
The best thing Nebraska's defense did, or Northwestern's defense did, was hold them on first down. Anytime you make this team push, especially when you get towards the red zone, that's been the biggest thing. And Newby's going to be a guy they're going to try to get the ball in multiple different ways, screen pass, downhill runs. He's been effective for them for this offense.
So now it's Drew Brown. That September 26th game against Southern Miss, 5 first half field goals to tie the NCAA record. Here's a 43-yard attempt to put Nebraska on top. And points on their first possession, a 3-0 lead for the Cornhuskers. One of the great environments in all of college football here at Memorial Stadium under first-year head coach Mike Riley. The Huskers grab the early lead. Nebraska honoring their 1995 national championship team here today. Tom Osborne's guys beat 4 top 10 opponents by an average of 31 points per game en route to that 12-0 season and the blowout of the Fiesta Bowl over the Florida Gators. Tommy Frazier is going to join Paul Carcaterra a little bit later on here in the first quarter to chat. They went back to back. Of course, they won it in 94 and then they won it again in 97 in that terrific stretch for the Cornhuskers. It's been a tough act to follow, too. A big shadow from Tom Osborne. Your name's on the field. You know you've done some things right over 25 seasons here at Nebraska, and now Mike Riley this season replacing Bo Pelini. Bill Callahan, Frank Solitz, the other guys that have been here since Osborne left. After that last championship, Solomon Vault is going to bring it out. Had a nice return in the opening kickoff that came back due to a penalty, and he'll get out across the 25. 29 yards on the return for Vault, a promising young playmaker for Northwestern. And the offensive unit will head back out there for the Cats.
Offside on the kicking team, number 15. 5-yard penalty added on the end of the run. First down.
Let's see, Anthony, what they can get done here on first down. Unfortunately for them, the worst first down team in FBS, and that has really set them back in terms of their scoring, their total offense, their passing attack, all amongst the worst in the country.
Yeah, and it's about setting the tone at the line of scrimmage. You know, you have a back like Justin Jackson who's got the capabilities of hitting the hole. They got to get those lanes open and block the second level so he can get yards. Last week they struggled against Iowa. And listen, North and Nebraska's defensive line knows this. They're going to make it hard for him.
Matt Fitzgerald talked about turning frustration into motivation all week long in practice to get ready for this game. And Thorson, he's a big guy, not afraid to run with it, and he finds a seam. The cutback inside the 25. Thorson streaking for the end zone. Knocked out around the goal line.
That's how you get your first down yardage up right there, a big run. And we talked about it before the game. He's got to use his legs. Pre-designed pass. Look at the big hole. That's the biggest thing. Get off your first read. Come back to your second. If it's not there, take off. And he obviously, for a big guy, has good speed down the sidelines. That's the difference. 68-yard run. That's how you spark an offense against a defense that's done well against the run this year.
71 yards total rushing for Thorson up until that scamper, and now it's first and goal. Jackson and Vitale in the eye. It's Justin Jackson slamming into a wall of black shirts. Dedrick Young, the true freshman linebacker, leading the way. Ian Aaron Williams, a couple of true freshmen, just the fourth and fifth true freshman to start out on defense since the rookies became eligible back in 72. Not very often here at Nebraska. They have always prided themselves on that D. Two superbacks in the game. The direct snap to Jackson as they run a little Wildcat. Going to come up short. It will be third and goal as Josh Banderas has the tackle.
They had a better snap there. Justin Jackson might have been able to squeak to his right and get in, but great job by him just catching the football. You don't want a disastrous play happening there with the ball going over your head. They'll go back to a more formidable offensive look here with the quarterback.
Power packages in with three super backs out there. Thorson tries to sneak, shove to the right, and he reaches across the goal line for the touchdown. 6'4" with a long reach, Anthony, and he found a way to get to the goal line.
Yeah, and he had his backs in the backfield just driving them and driving them in, and they finally get that last-ditch effort from behind. Danny Vitale, number 40. The question is, did he cross the line? You see here, they're driving Danny Vitale. They look like they stopped his charge initially, and then he slides off to the right. The question is, how do they deem that? They're not going to...
Okay to push, you just can't pull.
It isn't. And did he ever stop going forward? The question is, did the referee see that ball on his chest cross the line? He obviously has a better view than us from this angle.
I don't know if it was the initial thrust. It looks like when he reached over the second time.
And that'll be the biggest thing. If we can't see the football, we're not going to be able to change it, being that it was called a touchdown.
Jerry McGinn is on the horn to Greg Schmieding, the replay official.
Again, it looks like that ball's in his left arm, but you can't see the football. So, unfortunately, from that angle.
And nothing from the referee until right there when he starts running does he signal it.
And he looks like he has a clear as day view. Not a lot of linemen on that side of the football. They're all on the ground. So
at the review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
Well, Clayton Thorson is the guy that got him there, and he's the guy that gets him across. 6'3" Northwestern after that 68-yard run to set it all up.
Being in control, getting ahead in the football game, running, having balance, a mobile quarterback. That's the difference right now for this offense, first two series.
Extra point is good, and Northwestern responds, and they're up 7-3 following the longest run of the season for the Cats. They punch it in.
in Lincoln.
Well, thank you very much, Chris, as those two teams try and stay undefeated. If you're going for a national championship, you're going to be compared to these guys. Tom Osborne's 95 team being celebrated here today. They led the country scoring 52 points per game in that memorable 12-0 season. They dominated the best teams in the country against top 10 foes. They outscored them by 31, including that rout of the Gators in Fiesta Bowl. Their All-America quarterback, Tommy Frazier, in the house with a lot of his old mates today. Jordan Stevenson will not get back out to the 10-yard line. Tommy now with Paul Carcaterra.
With a legend, Beth. And Tommy, you have this experience with your teammates 20 years later, walking out of that tunnel, hearing that crowd. What was it like?
It was just like old days. It was back 95 to when we walked out of the tunnel for the first time. That it was the first year they did the tunnel walk. And it just brought back the memories of what we started here in the tradition and how the fans still get excited about when they see the 95 team walk out along with this current team walking out.
You beat teams by an average of 38 points. Why was that 95 team so dominant?
Because we're a brotherhood. We're a bunch of band of brothers who are, we truly trust each other. And we had one goal, to go out there and be competitive and to make sure that there was no doubt that once the game was over with, we were the best team that day.
In the national title game, that run against Florida.
You know, that was just another play to me. You know, I tell people all the time, that wasn't even my favorite play. I don't think they were trying to tag. I think we wore them down enough to where it made it easy for me. But it's a special play in history. It set the tone and showed people what that team was truly made of.
Tommy, that team, a lot of people say the best ever. What's your response to that?
They're right. We are the best ever. When you look at the stats, you look at the numbers, you know, it's a debatable question, but what we did and the way we did it, I don't think there's another team out there that say they did that way.
What's the latest with Tommy Frazier?
I'm just a working guy, a happy family man, and enjoying life.
Thanks for spending time with us.
You're welcome.
Always good to see Tommy Frazier and a lot of his teammates here from that 95, hard to believe 20 years ago, they win the national championship. Still confident as ever, I love it.
By the way, that was no ordinary run against Florida. Not too many players are doing those kind of runs that he made right there. Just one of the all-time great quarterbacks, ahead of his time for sure.
Back to this year's edition of the Huskers and another Tommy Armstrong on the rollout and the catch out at the 35-yard line. Jordan Westerkamp has a couple of 100-yard receiving days this year, and congratulations to Jordan. That catch the 100th of his career, and he's now 21 games in a row with at least one catch.
Again, Van Hoos is in the right spot, the cornerback for Northwestern. He slips, and Westerkamp is not going to drop the ball when you throw it in his area. Good job. We talked about Armstrong outside the right of the pocket. They got to force him and get him go left to stop those plays.
He loves this rivalry. He had a Hail Mary catch a few years ago to win it here for Nebraska. He's got the ball again. Out on the flat to the 40-yard line. Wrapped up by Igwebuke. We've already seen two Huskers down hurt and now Westerkamp injured after he hit the turf hard.
You see, he slams his shoulder down. This would be a huge loss if he can't continue to play. He's really their best receiver, Tommy Armstrong's number one target for this football team.
He stays on the sideline here on second down. Terrell Newby picks up a couple. It'll be third and short. We've talked about the new system. Some new things for Tommy Armstrong to deal with, including the loss of their top two playmakers a year ago, Amir Abdullah and Kenny Bell. So Westerkamp playing a big role for them this year.
Yeah, and we see him come back on the field now. He's a tough guy. He's a perfect receiver, a polished route runner. When you watch him, he'll really beat you one-on-one when he's lined up with those inside linebackers and strong safeties.
He is slotted to the near side. Four receivers here on third down. Armstrong looking for the wheel route. Newby catches it out of bounds. Incomplete fourth down. Got behind Jalen Prater.
big play, and we talked about it. Watch the patience. He lets this play develop. Newbie's not initially open. He's got to reset his feet, though. See how his feet are opened up? He doesn't get his front foot ahead of him, and he doesn't make a catchable ball. And right there, it's so close. But if he just gets that ball in front of him in the field of play, it's going to be a huge catch for Terrell Newbie.
So the punting unit is out there on 4th and 3. Miles Schuler is the deep man. Sam Foltz, the 3-year starter, back to boot it away. High booming kick back inside the 5, and the fair catch at the 3-yard line by Miles Schuler, who should have let that one go and shot it to touchback. Instead, they will be buried deep after the 55-yard boot. Here in Lincoln, Nebraska, 7-3. Northwestern with the lead. Iowa right now the top of the standings in the West at 3-0. Overall still unbeaten, sitting on a bye this week. And they have the win over Northwestern a week ago. And really, Anthony, there's not much wiggle room now for these two teams. Got to win out to try and stay in the race. Iowa still has to come here at the end of the season.
You're right. Both teams do or die. Both have 2 losses. A third would be devastating for either program within the West, trying to catch an undefeated Iowa team right now.
Under pressure in the end zone. And down he goes. And the safety for Nebraska as the defense comes through. They got to Clayton Thorson.
Bringing pressure in from the quarterback, and right there they ran a little inside stunt by their defensive end. Nobody's open in coverage, and that's been a big issue right now with Nebraska. They do a great job, and again, no one slides off to block them. Number 88, DeZuris, does an excellent job of just running an inside stunt and gets the quarterback, and here comes the cavalry. And again, something that Nebraska needed to jump on early on defense. They did a good job, and it all goes back to Miles on that punt return, fair catching it. Schuler, number 5, a senior, on the 4-yard line. That was crucial in that decision, not letting that ball bounce into the end zone.
So Nebraska comes through with the defense to make it 7-5, and now the Huskers will get the ball here with the potential to be in great field position. We've talked about the injuries on the defensive side of the ball, and you know, Mike Riley talks about trying to find positives. Well, one of those is you get a lot of your reserves that get a lot of playing time and an opportunity to be out there, and DeZuris is one of those guys that has been in the mix more, and he comes up with the safety. Number 2, Jordan Stevenson, with a flag down as he goes down around the 38-yard line, 17 yards on the return.
During the return, legal block in the back, number 43, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, first down.
We've got another big game from the Big Ten coming up tonight. On Saturday Night Football, presented by Walmart, undefeated and top-ranked Ohio State visiting Rutgers. Who's in for the college football playoff? Well, the Buckeyes won it all last year. They seem to be in the driver's seat to get one of those top 4 spots again this season. Ohio State, Rutgers at 8 o'clock on ABC. That's also streaming on your Watch ABC app. Off of the safety now. Armstrong has Newbie in as the eye back. And the pass incomplete, looking for Jamal Turner. Of course, the big news for the Buckeyes tonight is the switch at quarterback. JT Barrett will get the start.
I think this should have been the starting quarterback to start the season. I think the offense flows. You look at the red zone offense, much better with JT Barrett in the game and yards per play. But to me, I just think when you talk about running that read option, run pass option, he brings the biggest movement in that position to make them successful. And to me, I think you're going to see a huge swing in the offense tonight in that game.
Oklahoma State will take a 20-game winning streak into New Jersey for that one. Terrell Newby with the carry. Jordan Thompson, who is making his first career start today, the true freshman out of Cincinnati with the stop. He's going to bring up third and 7.
Again, passing down situation. Let's just watch the helmet and eyes of the quarterback here and see how he reads through and improved himself in his progressions.
Northwestern will bring some pressure, the five-man rush. Armstrong looking for Westerkamp, and a flag is down. Now the coverage of Keith Watkins.
Pass interference. Defense, number 3. Ball be placed in the spot of the foul. Automatic. First down.
Keith Watkins, number 3, obviously holding the wide receiver in the slot. Right there, pulls him away. He's getting his second start. Their top corner, Matthew Harris, as a junior, is out of this game. So he has to step in, fill the void right now for this defense.
First and 10. Good morning, Pearson L out in the open. Picks up a few down to Paul Carcaterra.
Good news for Nebraska. Wide receiver Jordan Westerkamp is just back in the game after being nicked up. And that has been Tommy Armstrong's blanket in terms of his security in the new offense. Anthony, the one thing that stayed the same is Westerkamp. And Westerkamp's been his roommate for over 3 years. And his message to Jordan against this Northwestern defense: match the physicalities of the Northwestern linebackers in the slot.
On second down. Catch on the move. Brandon Riney. First down yardage. Gets down inside the 40. Got a nice block from Jamal Turner, a 24-yard gain. And Anthony, you really like this receiving unit as a group.
Yeah, they do a great job catching ball. Well, look at ball placement right there. That's the biggest thing that I watch from this Armstrong as a quarterback, trying to put the ball in position so the receivers can catch it and get up the field fast. Perfect example right there of when a receiver can catch a ball in front of him, how deadly he can be on the outside.
Two tight ends will line up to the left on first down. Newby tries to cut back up the middle. Got down to about the 36. He's the junior out of Los Angeles, taking over for Amir Abdullah this year. Had that big game against Minnesota, a couple of touchdowns, including the 69-yard touchdown run and their big win on the road last week.
Hard act to follow Amir Abdullah, obviously, yeah, playing for the Lions right now. Back-to-back 1,600-yard seasons. They have a 1,000-yard rusher the last 6 seasons, so hopefully he'll be on pace to continue that track.
He is on pace to do just that. Setting up the screen here for their tight end, Carter, and he slams through a defender close to the first down. And a flag on the play as he ran right over Travion Henry. Oohs and ahs from the crowd on the replay.
Personal foul, legal block below the waist. Offense, number 57. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Remains second down.
And that's the right tackle, Zach Stirrup.
You see Seathan, obviously, you see that bottom left, the chop block. Nice to see physicality at the tight end position. Unfortunately, it doesn't count, but right there, that's how you set the tempo. When a safety steps up, you better get lower. Number 2, Travion Henry, in a bad spot right there on flat feet, getting pushed back.
After the penalty and the pass, incomplete, intended for Carter. How about an update on Baylor? Chris?
Yeah, now it's time for Shore to Shore, brought to you by Joe's Crab Shack. And, well, weather is ugly down there in Waco. It's pouring, and when Baylor's playing, especially against Iowa State, it's raining offense. 21-0, that shocked Linwood there. Still in the first, Ben.
Well, you talk about weapons, not only with Shaq Linwood, but Seth Russell at quarterback, Corey Coleman leading the country with those 16 touchdown catches to start the day.
And who set up Iowa State's schedule? They had to go Texas Tech, TCU, then Baylor, back to back to back, not very good.
Top three scoring teams in the country for the Cyclones. The catch here is made by Newby. Gets some of that yardage back. Picks up seven. But it's going to be fourth down. So the penalty ends up hurting. Northwestern may be able to get away with only giving up the safety and not getting hurt by the field position. Miles Schuler is back deep again to receive the punt.
He looks like he knows where he is right now on the 10-yard line. If he has to take one step back, let it go.
You think the coaches said, do not move your heels. He came forward, as a matter of fact, and that one will bound into the end zone for the touchback. Well, tonight on ESPN, college football primetime presented by Hilton. That's the only matchup of ranked teams on the day, Texas A&M and Ole Miss. And then number 10 Stanford taking on Washington. Both games on ESPN and on the Watch ESPN app. There's a look at your SEC West standings with LSU leading the charge. Ole Miss and A&M, the loser of that one may fall out of contention.
Laramie Tunsil, the star-studded left tackle, is back. He's going against Miles Garrett, the top pass rusher. Looking forward to watching that matchup.
Both those teams coming off of tough losses a week ago. And of course, for Northwestern fans, very familiar with that Stanford Cardinal team. You talk about the last two losses for the Wildcats, but they've got a couple of nice wins on that resume as well with Stanford and Duke.
Yeah, you're right. They start out the season with a bang, and you see here with this offense, they have the running yards up right now in this football game. Got to continue to stay on schedule and grind it out.
Thorson with the pitch to Vitale. Read well by the defense for Nebraska. If nothing else, Northwestern has gotten on the board here in the first quarter, Anthony, after falling behind 21-0 against Michigan and 16-0 against Iowa in those two losses.
Yeah, special teams against Michigan, Michigan when they played them, and also the early interception by Thorson in the first series last week against Iowa cost them dearly. So far, he's playing a solid game.
Third and seven. Thorson looking for Vitale, and a wounded duck after Malik Collins put some pressure on the quarterback. Fourth down.
Well, if there's anybody on the football field that they needed to worry about today, it was number seven, Malik Collins. He runs a stunt here on the inside, and he's going to come rush the quarterback. Stunts outside, and you cannot block him. He's got mobility. He's got speed to come around the edge. Circled the wrong guy, but I think we get the picture who the big playmaker is up front.
Peters away. Thorson at it. The first guy there for Northwestern thought that a fair catch was called. He let him go. It's a 31-yard punt, and Pearsonell ended up losing a few on the return. Well, for the Northwestern Wildcats, that strong start. They jump out to 5-0 on the season, highlighted by that big win against Stanford. The Cardinal have not lost since. But the last couple of games, forgettable ones. Blasted by Michigan in the Big House, and then Iowa ran all over them in the second half last week for a 40-10 win. And Northwestern trying to get back into the win column.
I talked to Coach Fitzgerald before the game, and he told me, listen, we pulled the pads off this week in practice, and I like that. They played some physical games. You talked about Iowa last week. It's been huge. Good idea by him to get his guys, their bodies back, and against a physical game against a team they need to beat today.
Wanted those guys to find out, are we going to be the 5-0 team or the 0-2 team? That's their challenge today in hostile territory, especially when the Huskers are celebrating their 95 national championship team. But the young quarterback, Clayton Thorson, had a huge play. Nebraska bringing it defensively as well. 7-5, Northwestern with the lead over Nebraska. You're watching College Football presented by 5-Hour Energy. Just one first down in the first quarter for the Wildcats, but they took advantage of it to score. And now Armstrong with Newby in the backfield. And Tommy Armstrong starting out 8-for-14 on the day, Anthony.
We talked about his feet, and it's not just sitting in the pocket and stepping forward. It's also when the pocket breaks down, getting yourself adjusted so you have an open path. Right there, throws flat-footed, and that last pass in the series before, again, throws with his body square and open. He just slides to his right, gives himself a better opportunity to make that pass down the field.
Through his career, he's been a shade over 50% in terms of accuracy, and that's about where he is this year under this new system. The pass incomplete. Down to Paul.
Anthony, pocket presence, and what Tommy Armstrong emphasized this week when we spoke on the phone, he said understanding down and distance. Earlier in his career, he's running. He's got to preserve his body, become more of that quarterback in the pocket that Mike Riley wants.
Trying to figure out for him as a quarterback when to stay and when not, and I think the thing that's happening is when he's running, there's guys open down the field to what Paul's alluding to, and then when he's not running, he should be running. So they just need him to get clarity, and that's all comes down to reading the progression down the football field.
Sam Foltz end over the head of Shuler, and that would drop inside the five and into the end zone for the touchback, 48 yards. Kick. 7-5, Northwestern on a spectacular autumn day here in Lincoln. Now the first rankings from the selection committee, which includes Tom Osborne, will come out a week from Tuesday. 7-5, Clayton Thorson, a 68-yard run in their 10 other plays for the offense, just 3 yards total. Husker D also got a safety in that first quarter. Thorson incomplete behind Garrett Dickerson. To the studio and an update from Chris.
Texas back in action following that win over Oklahoma. K-State coming off a 55-0 loss to Oklahoma. And Charlie Strong's team, pretty strong. 10-0 right now. That was Tyrone Swoops. And Houston unbeaten but getting a game from 0-7 UCF right now.
Simon Brooks, and a nice job by Nebraska to stretch that one out, and it's third down.
That stretch run is something they've been trying to attack against this Nebraska's defense. No seams open for this football team. You talk about Clayton Thorson passing the football, hasn't been accurate. Now you're behind the sticks. This is a tough spot for Northwestern in this position.
Five receivers now in the game. The motion in into the backfield. Four-man rush for Nebraska. Thorson's pass complete to Vault. He's tracked down from behind by Malik Collins. Fourth down. Collins, the two-year starter, the junior out of Kansas City, menacing up front for the Huskers.
Brings up fourth down and 8 from the 22-yard line. Accurate punt.
Personnel back deep. When we talked to Pat Fitzgerald this week, he said, "I prefer my punter, Hunter Nicewander, kick it to me or Mike Riley on the sideline instead of kicking it to Personnel and giving him a chance." 3 punt return TDs last year, and this one will come up way short. And a nice bounce, though, for Northwestern. Down to the 36-yard line. It ends up going 41 yards and may have been tipped on that one by the Nebraska special teams, Andy Janovich. Seven to five, the Wildcats leading the Huskers, 12-31 to go here in the first half. Anthony, back to your playoff contenders as we get closer to the rankings coming out.
And I've had this preseason, so I'm gonna stick with it, Beth. And you look at Ohio State, they're kind of my Florida State for this year from last year's season. TCU, to me, Gary Patterson's got that offense cooking. Defense is holding the fort down. They'll be challenged later on. LSU, again, Brandon Harris and Fournette right now have been a nice combination. He's been able to make some passes in the play game. And Stanford, has anybody played better on offense than that?
Stanford Stanford's lone loss was to this Northwestern team and his newbie out to the 45 and a gain of 8. You can see the Buckeyes tonight on ABC. Stanford is at home tonight on ESPN.
Ohio State, we talked about JT Barrett getting the start, and I expect that offense to be cooking tonight. This could be the catapult for this team to start making that run and that push and getting that separation in the Big Ten.
Still have 14 unbeaten around the country, 3 of them in the Big Ten and 3 more in the Big 12, and then 3 still in the American Conference, as Temple and Memphis have both won already this week. Wrapped up. It's going to be a third down and short. Anthony Walker with the tackle. Houston in a dogfight today. Temple back in your Philly home, hosting the Fighting Irish next Saturday night.
A big game there. Biggest game in Temple history. Sold out crowd. I'll tell you what, that's going to be one ghoulish game on Halloween.
Oh.
How about that?
Is there a push to get game day back to Philly?
They're talking about it. You know, I'll tell you, it'd be a fun atmosphere to bring game day up to Philly.
Ozigbo is now in a tailback on third and a couple. Against the four-man rush, and it's batted down at the line of scrimmage. And the fist pump from number 93, Greg Kuhar. Junior out of Concord Township, Ohio, and it's fourth down.
Stop by them on defense. They had a crossing route underneath. They're going to get the ball off, and he gets right in the vision of Armstrong, knocks it down. Good to see Kuhar back on the field last year, out for the season. They've slowly gotten him back in, coming off an injury. Obviously makes a huge play for the defense and forces a punt.
Fourth straight punt here for Nebraska. Hewley will let this one bounce, and it will squirt into the end zone for the touchback. That one had a lot of ground to cover, and it still got there for Northwestern. Now let's take a look at this week's rankings, brought to you by Northwestern Mutual. Ohio State, Baylor, Utah, and TCU in the top 4 spots. That's the projection right now from the FBI, the Football Power Index, and the folks at ESPN.
And those out west think have USC, an unranked opponent. They're favored in this game. I don't think that's happened in over 20 years. Never happened. When you look at Michigan State, no one's really talking about them. They had that close last-second win on special teams against Michigan. They kept falling back a spot, but they continue to win week in and week out.
Spartans and the Buckeyes undefeated over in the East. Solomon Vault with the carry. Freedom Akinmolodun with the stop. He's one of the guys that is coming back from injury today, along with Michael Rose Ivy and Daniel Davey in the secondary. It's been what they called a linebacker merry-go-round in the middle of the field, so they're happy to have Rose Ivy back. Deep ball. Looking for Cam Dickerson down to Paul.
Pat Fitzgerald said earlier in the week, this team's got to make a decision. Is it the team that went out and won 5 games and made plays all over the place, or the team that in the last 2 weeks, quite frankly, is void of making plays? One first down today, Anthony.
They lack explosiveness on offense. When you get Nebraska to punt 4 times in a row, Beth, you got to convert on third down and move the chains. Right now, they have not had that spark since Thorson's run.
Just 4 yards passing today. Could be a free play here, and it's almost intercepted. A flag down at the line of scrimmage. Chris Jones had it and couldn't hold on.
Offside. Defense, number 7. 5-yard penalty, third down.
That was Malik Collins trying to get a head start.
They jump the gun right in the middle. Back over the center. Defensive tackle jump, so had a free play. This is a much better situation for this Northwestern offense. And, you know, to me, number 40, Danny Vitale, on the bottom of the screen, lined up on the line of scrimmage, could be a target on this down distance.
Here comes the pressure. Thorson in trouble, and down he goes. Wrapped up by Nate Gary, coming out of the secondary, and it's fourth down. C second sack of the day for Mark Banker's defensive unit.
They're going to bring pressure on the top of the screen. Back does a nice job of stopping the charge. He's got an underneath route right underneath to get the ball, but he can't get it out of his hands. Justin Jackson, again, it's always a tough matchup when you're going against a D lineman. But again, Thorson has to understand what pressure's coming and has to hit the quick target.
Nice wander, tried to boot that one to Pat Fitzgerald as it scoots out of bounds. But that should set up the Huskers nicely. A couple offenses struggling so far in the first half. Well, Mike Riley, known for his offensive mind, they're coming off that nice win against Minnesota. You put up 48 points on the road, but the offense has been problematic so far here in the first half with four consecutive punts, and they have just the field goal. The other points coming on a safety.
I think that's huge. You're at home. You're going against a team in Northwestern whose offense has struggled throughout the season. Don't let them hang around and keep working plays, working plays. You got to take advantage of it on your side of the football. You got to convert points on this drive right here.
Northwestern has just 67 total yards, only one first down, and the lead. Second down, Newby slices his way inside the 40. It'll bring up third and a couple. Anthony Walker grabbed him, brought him down.
Five tackles in the first quarter. You see him in open space. He's going to get his chances today. Anytime they run that stretch play, which they got beat by last week against Iowa, that cutback linebacker has to be in place. Wasn't there last week. Walker in position this week. Makes a big tackle.
They can find Westerkamp here on third down. They'll go to Newby out of the backfield. Westerkamp with a nice block, and they've got the first down to the 35. Stanley Morgan was also out there doing his job on the edge.
Accountable receiver, does everything right. Coach's dream, really, when he's on the football field. Catches the ball, blocks, can break the big one. Just one of those players that Nebraska just is about the tradition. He's one of those guys that fits the boat.
He'll go slot left this time. Walker blitzing up the middle, and the pass incomplete. Broken up by Igwebuke, intended for Westerkamp. Well, we'll get you ready for your NFL Sunday tomorrow. First, it's NFL Insider Sunday edition with Week 7 injury news, fantasy updates, and early breaking stories. That's at 10 Eastern, and then at 11, Boomer and the Boys for Sunday NFL Countdown. We'll take you right up to kickoff. Both of those shows are also streaming live on Watch ESPN. Second and 10, Armstrong goes under center. Newby. Down inside the 30, and that'll set him up again. Third and short. Deontay Gibson with the stop.
Downhill inside. Got to mix it up. That's what Nebraska's known for. Their big linemen over the years getting that push up front. Right now it's a huge play when you're long distance and second down, deciding to go to run, get those big chunks, put you in a favorite position. Armstrong's got to be accurate on this play here.
2 of 7 on third down against one of the best third down D's in the country. Armstrong. Doesn't have his feet right, and it's intercepted. And a lot of green grass in front, unless Tommy can get there to make the play. And Nick Van Hoos with a pick six. 72 yards. Hughes makes a nice play and takes it the other way. And now both defensive units today have put some points on the board, but more importantly for Northwestern, a touchdown for them. Jack Mitchell with the PAT. Nick Van Hoos, pick six, and it's 14-5 Wildcats.
Thing that Armstrong is doing when he's looking at this pass play is he's looking left, trying to find behind his tight end initially. You see his eyes looking right here at the tight end. Linebacker's in position to make that play. Now he wants to come back right because he's got an outlet to the outside in his running back. When he turns his body around, the problem is the defender jumps it and he doesn't see Van Hoosen coming from the safety position down. Again, when you're falling down as a quarterback, the best option there is maybe just take the sack, because the problem is you compound it with the potential of an interception. And right there, a teaching moment for Armstrong. Got to be smarter with the football when he's coming back across the field.
The senior making his 40th start today in the secondary for Northwestern. And the defensive unit comes up big.
Again, you just can't have those mistakes on the field. And you talk about this game, Northwestern's got one run by a quarterback and an interception for a touchdown, and that's all they've done, and they have a lead. And Nebraska's sitting here with all the weapons in the world to use on offense, and they're really just shooting themselves in the foot right now.
The story is Clayton Thorson with a 68-yard run. Good for their only first down of the day. And then in their other 16 plays, they are negative 1 yards. But that run set up a touchdown, and now their defense scores four.
They're falling right into the trap. This is what Northwestern wants. They love these kind of games. This is like a Pat Fitzgerald special here. Kind of an ugly game. They got the lead, and Nebraska's trying to find themselves. Nebraska, Thorson and this team for Northwestern likes their situation right now. I think right now, if you're Nebraska on offense, you got to find ways to get first down yardage. I think the last couple series they haven't done that. They got to get this crowd going. You got to see it red here. You got the 95 team. You got to build off this. I think a big explosive play down the field. Chuck one down to Moore, number 82. He's been a big play target down the field. Try to get one-on-one coverage and let the ball go up to see if he can make a play, kind of recharge this offense.
Strong so far today is 9 for 19. Through the air, they have run the ball for 56 yards so far in the first half. The give is to Janovich, the fullback.
Love the fullback, but that's not charging me up as a play, watching plays from upstairs in the box. Again, getting real conservative now, running a lot of two tight end sets, getting the ball inside. To me, you don't want to lose confidence if you're the offensive coordinator. Danny Lansdorf is a guy that's working on this transition with this quarterback, and you got to keep feeding him and giving those opportunities and take what the defense gives you.
Strong on second and long with a couple of tight ends. Has time. Incomplete. Underthrows Seathan Carter.
Runs an over route, just sticks it in there with a little more zip, tries to drop it in, and Hoos does a nice job of just falling back. That's the big play right there that they just missed. The series before the interception, they had a wide open slant route, inaccurate on the pass. Again, Armstrong, they got to get him going. These quick passes might be the way to go, but in long distance situations at third down, right now I can't believe the quarterback's confidence is very high.
Well, the last third down, Anthony, resulted in a pick six for Nick Van Hoos. This one's 3rd and 9. Pressure coming off his back foot again, and this time he makes the connection for the first down to Brandon Riley.
I would suggest throwing off your back foot. Again, he's got the pressure. Great route by the wide receiver, getting the separation from the defensive back, Brandon Riley. But watch the quarterback now. As he's rolling out, he saw the same thing before. Gets that pressure and just kind of chucks it. Very lucky in ball placement there, but that could have been disastrous again for the quarterback.
Going through some growing pains, or as Mike Riley described it to us yesterday, it's been a roller coaster for this offense, learning a new system under their first-year head coach. The offense, which was so spectacular during his tenure at Oregon State. Morgan with the grab out around the 45. 6-yard pickup.
You see the arm strength for him coming across the field. And, Mike Riley talked about, he brings so many great attributes to the game. obviously he's a good runner. They just want to build him as a passer, and they've only been able to really transfer both of their offenses to what they really want to do on offense. But they feel like right now the biggest thing from the quarterback position is feet and making quicker decisions.
They thought he was better at it last week. Build upon it, and they will run it here on second down. Newbie maybe a yard. Greg Kuhar with the tackle. And it'll be third down. Need a couple here to keep this drive alive. Armstrong looked solid last week in that win against Minnesota. Three touchdown passes, 299 yards of total offense. Trying to find that balance, when to stay in the pocket and when to go with it. Completion percentage way up last week. Armstrong will keep. He's able to dive out to the 49 for the first down. Dean Lowry couldn't haul him down by the jersey.
Dean Lowry's a very stout defensive end, and they're going to pull the running backs, the backside tight end, try to get the quarterback outside. They got him wrapped up in the backfield, but Armstrong, such a great athlete. Of course, number 35, Janovich, the unsung hero, doing the blocks down the field, never gets the credit he deserves. Blocked a punt earlier, doing a good job.
He's the up back in the eye right now. Newbie hit at midfield and into Northwestern territory. The Baylor Bears must be doing something again. Chris?
Good guess, Beth. 2 years ago when Iowa State went to Baylor, they lost 71-7. It's now 35-0. This made it 28-0. Seth Russell to shock Linwood. No shocker here. Beth?
49-yard line.
Thank you very much, Chris. I've got that on an endless loop. I'm just going to keep. Baylor must be doing something again offensively. What a terror they have been. 6-0, scoring on the average of 64 points per game. On the roll. And the catch is made up to the 30-yard line. Jamal Turner, 19 yards, and another first down.
And Northwestern coming in on defense, they wanted to force Armstrong to his left, but this is a designed rollout to the left. Nice play action there, and he gets his feet around and is able to get the target down with the football. Watch him turn his shoulders, that's key, and he throws a gun strike to the wide receiver on the outside. Well done, good play call, move the chains.
Out of the eye cross, slammed in the backfield. Dean Lowry, the senior out of Rockford, Illinois. We keep hearing about the job that Baylor's doing. We don't have any playoff right now, the Bears. So that, schedule an issue for you?
Right now it is. It's early. The big tests are coming. The Oklahomas, the TCUs. I want to see them play those teams. And they start knocking them out and doing the same things they're doing against Iowa State and company. And I'll definitely switch that around. But until I see it, I can't project them in that situation.
Not buying in yet on the Brazos. Second and 16. After the good defensive effort from the Cats. Looking for Connor, incomplete. Broken up by Van Hoos, who had a bead on that one again.
Van Hoos doing a real nice job out there, leaving the vertical route, watching the quarterback get it down underneath. And again, it looked like the deep route was open, but it was actually his play and his eyes tracking that football to be in position to help out and defending that pass. He's done a nice job. You talked about it earlier. His 40th start today, second team all Big Ten last year, 30 pass defense in his career, a house call last series. Great job in this football game.
11th play of this drive, but it's third and 16, and Northwestern will call the timeout. 2:19 to go in the half, Northwestern on top. Celebrating its 10th year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kicked. Allstate has donated millions in scholarship funds. Third and 16 for Nebraska. Armstrong rolling to his left. The throw and field to Wester Camp around the 15, and he's got it for the first down. Here for Nebraska.
And really, that's all Armstrong. he wants to stay in the pocket, and Northwestern does what they want. They roll him to the left. But again, getting his shoulders around, and Westerkamp always finding the holes. Big play receiver down the field. Great job throwing on the run. Hasn't been one of his favorable positions to throw, but right there comes up big again.
Longest play of the day for the offense, 25-yard pickup. Strong with the designed run, looking for an opening, and none presents itself. Gets back to the line of scrimmage, second and goal.
You know, when you talk about seniors or juniors and guys that have played the game a lot, Westerkamp's a guy that when he finds the areas, he's able to find the open spots, gets his hand up, and when he's running, he feels where safeties and corners are, so he gets that proper depth in his route. Complete receiver, smart, and he's an accountable guy, and that's why Armstrong continues to go after him play after play.
Second and goal. Armstrong, patient, delivers, touchdown. Brandon Riley waited for him to clear across the middle and got him for six.
Offensive line, phenomenal job in protection. Actually gets Armstrong in his eyes.
Plays 75 yards. They had three third down conversions on that drive to keep it going. The 25 yard pass to Westerkamp, the big one. And Riley with his second touchdown catch of the season. The extra point is good. 7 to go in the half, and it's now 14-12.
Great job of protection up front. Watch Armstrong. He wants to go to the back to the right, but because of the protection, he takes his eyes off this player and comes back in to Brandon Riley, and Riley just runs the shallow cross route. Again, you want to set your feet and throw, but his arm's strong enough to get him across the field. But the offensive line, you see the center, the guards, Condola. Again, Armstrong's feet's not perfect, but he's able to salvage it with his strong arm. And Riley running a nice route across the field. But the offensive lineman we haven't talked about, Condolo, Reeves, the center, really good at protecting and making that pocket big.
Looked like Anthony Walker, the middle linebacker, was passing him off to Jalen Prater, and there was a miscommunication there as to who was supposed to pick up Brandon.
Six, and two of those completions of those five are rolling to the left, with Northwestern's defensive coordinator said that they wanted to force him to do it.
Shoot, breaks a tackle and gets out across the 25. 1:02 to go in the half. Chris, what do we got coming up at halftime?
Well, coming up with the Dave and Buster's halftime report, we will talk about the thrashing down in Waco. The rain is falling, and so are the Iowa State Cyclones to the Baylor Bears. Clemson is controlling things against Miami. The Hurricanes with a quarterback issue, and Butch Davis, Robert Smith on the nice quarterback issue we have at Ohio State. That's coming up.
All right, thank you very much, Chris. Here in Lincoln, the statistics don't really tell the story, as Nebraska has run 30 more plays on offense than Northwestern has. But Northwestern had the one big play that led to a touchdown and a pick six to get them the lead, and now they're trying to hurry to get some more on the board.
And Northwestern gets two timeouts. No huddle situation, trying to get across the field, potentially set up for a field goal.
Thorson to the tally. Bottled up right around the yard to gain, but his forward progress will move the chains and stop the clock for a moment. Josh Banderas with the tackle. Away from the pressure and then finds a man. And another first down toss, this to Mike McHugh.
I don't think he got his feet down. He caught it in the air, fell out of bounds. That's not going to get Defense does a nice job. Watch, he's in the air. Very smart knocking him out of bounds on that play. Chris Jones does a nice job. Much maligned defensive backfield for Nebraska. Coming up big on that play right there.
So instead, it's second and 10 again from the 40. Five wides.
Christian Jones right here trying to attack the middle of the field. He got timeouts if you can get him in the middle.
Thorson stepping up. He's got the first down and another huge play by the quarterback with his legs. Inside the 15, and he gets out of bounds at the 11 with 8 seconds still on the clock. 49 yards to go along with his 68-yard run earlier.
I'll tell you what, Thorson is showing his running ability. Great job in the pocket, just having control and awareness. Right here, big chance for Gary. 25 strong safety to make the tackle, just scoots inside. All the way down the field, puts himself in a great situation. Again, two timeouts left, 8 seconds. They got a chance here to go into the end zone.
One pass play, and if you don't get it, you bring the field goal unit on. Unbelievable for Clayton Thorson. Their total yards for Northwestern, 128. He has run in two plays for 106.
Coaches talked about this, and we talked to Mike McCall, their offensive coordinator. They want him to use his legs more. And right there, brings the ball down. But just to have that situation.
Correction. That's the second of the half. Second of the half.
His yardage a little down from the actual two runs because he lost some yardage on his other plays. This was the one that led to the touchdown early.
You know, really thinking you need a spy against someone like Thorson. But early on in the season, he was a big part of what this offense was doing, along with Justin Jackson. And he's really taking this game on right here. Great move inside to get away from a DB. And look at the stiff arm right there. This kid's trying to get those yards, does a nice job. I tell you, Thorson's been a subtle surprise today for me in his running ability down the field.
Didn't play last year. Watched Trevor Siemian, the starter. So this is his first year with the job at 6'4", 220 out of Wheaton, Illinois, with the longest two runs of his career here today.
Again, Danny Vitale, number 40. He got him lined up as the second receiver. Right here, watch him. He caught a touchdown going underneath Christian Jones earlier in the season. See if they try to attack the middle of the field right now where there's no safety.
Timeout will be called by Nebraska.
Timeout. Nebraska.
Game going on right now.
First of the
both
half.
Teams.
Yeah, 30-second charge. Timeout.
They were showing blitz from the left side, so the Wildcats got Solomon Vault back into the backfield to help out blocking, and Riley wants to talk about it. With 8 seconds to go, this college football Saturday. Why just watch one when you can watch them all? Get a game on your big screen, another on your computer, another one on your tablet, and even a fourth on your smartphone. Use Watch ESPN app and download the app or go to watchESPN.com. These two teams, both 1-2 in the West, really cannot afford another loss to fall even further behind undefeated Iowa.
Northwestern's going to be in the same formation. Vitale, number 40. Jones 14, both guys 6'3". Those are the targets. No one else can get this ball for Thorson when you throw this down in the end zone. Now they have a safety in the middle of the field for Nebraska, so it's a good timeout for them to take and get their guys in the right spots.
Looking left the whole way, the pass into the end zone, caught initially and then ruled incomplete as Christian Jones did not hang on through the catch, and he had six.
This has been a common theme the last 2 weeks with Christian Jones, one of their more reliable receivers, but he's had some drops. Remember, folks, you got to catch the ball, come down to the ground, and you have to finish the catch all the way through. As he's rolling through, the ball pops out there late. Tough to see on that angle. We'll see it here. He catches the ball, body rolls. Doesn't complete the catch. The problem is how many rolls or when do you consider him down?
Yeah, 30 seconds. Timeout.
Christian Jones had a rough week last week with the drops against Iowa. And a certain TD goes by the wayside here.
When he catches and rolls, folks, you think, oh, the ball's in his control for a while. When you actually run this in game speed, that ball's popping out underneath. But again, the rule states
previous play as far as the reception in the end zone.
The catch when you're falling to the ground needs to be full and complete. So again,
even though the shoulder's down, even though the back and the backside are down on that roll, could not hang on. They will review it anyway, since it is a scoring play, but the ruling on the field is an incompletion.
And they ran exactly what we drew up. They had Christian Jones go to the right underneath. They ran Vitale across the middle, and they went away from the safety. So good choice by Thorson. Jones runs a nice route. Again, completing the catch all the way through.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Incomplete pass. Northwestern will be charged with final charge timeout and may not challenge for the rest of the game.
That's unfortunate for this football team, because they had a touchdown there. If he just hold on to the ball, well-designed play, missed opportunity. Now they go from touchdown to field goal. Nebraska gets a break.
And important to note, that was not an official's review. That was a challenge, as you hear them say. So they do not have a challenge left in the second half. Jack Mitchell, a 28-yard attempt. He's 11 for 15 on the season. And somehow got that one up and through. Pressure coming from Nebraska. And Mitchell gets 3 points on the board as time expires. 17 to 12. Wildcats. A couple of long Clayton Thorson runs to set up the scores for the offense. Now let's go to Chris Hassel, Butch Davis, and Robert Smith on our Dave and Buster's halftime report. You're watching college football presented by 5-Hour Energy. 17 to 12, Northwestern on the road with the lead over Nebraska as we get set to start the second half. Two big plays from Clayton Thorson and a pick six, the difference for Northwestern. And it's been a roller coaster ride throughout the season, adjusting to the new offense for Nebraska, and that ride has continued. We've seen some good stuff from Tommy Armstrong, and we've seen some ill-fated decisions as well. Nebraska deferred after winning the toss, so they will receive here to start out this third quarter. So Nebraska will have it at its own 25-yard line. Beth Mullins, Anthony Beck, Paul Carcaterra also with us on this beautiful day here in Lincoln. We talked about the quarterbacks early, and they've been the story here throughout this first half.
Well, we talked about getting the ball to Justin Jackson for Northwestern. Well, the quarterback, Clayton Thorson, has been the running guy on their side of the football, and he's made some big plays with his legs. And right now, Nebraska's done a great job on defense, except for two snaps.
Yeah, we thought that they would be able to run the ball a little bit more, Northwestern, and we thought it would be Jackson, but instead it's been Thorson. His two long running plays for 117 yards. Their other 20 plays just netted 11 yards for the Northwestern offense. Yeah! They have the lead. And for Tommy Armstrong, it's been an up and down day so far.
The Coach Riley talked about the roller coaster, and this is two of the plays that were poor. Doesn't set his feet, getting the ball down the field, and when he comes back, you got to understand, you can't throw off balance, take the sack instead of compounding it. But then he rolls to his left. Northwestern wanted to do that on defense, and two of his best throws came to the left-hand side. And then finding the underneath crosser, which got them the score late in the second quarter, was a big play, able to bounce back. You got to like that about the kid.
Was over 50% in that first half, and the miscue and the frustration from Jamal Turner unable to hang on. Gerald Newby, 11 rushes for 46 yards. He was their top guy on the ground. They dominated in terms of time of possession. They ran 25 more plays than Northwestern did. But for Mike Riley, he saw his punter out there way too much.
Yeah, he wants to see consistency. They had their best outing on offense last week against Minnesota. He needed to see it go back-to-back in this week. Right now, the offense has struggled. And with the quarterback situation, he's got to get this game moving.
That's across the middle. Ethan Carter, the junior out of New Orleans, the tight end with the grab, and it's good for a first down, down to Paul Carcaterra.
Beth, I just caught up with Mike Riley, head coach of Nebraska. He said no rhythm offensively. They can't run the ball against Northwestern. He said they have to find it in the pass game with Tommy Armstrong. He said don't rule out a trick play either. Defensively, really happy. Obviously, this is a unit that was last in the nation against the pass, 341 yards a game, 16 yards.
Play, completed catches under further review.
Well, thank you, Paul. And now they will go back, the officials, and take a look at that first down catch from Carter. Also of note, since Nebraska has been involved in so many close games this year, Northwestern did use up its challenge in the first half. They do not have one left here in the second. This is the official review from upstairs in the replay booth.
What a question. Once Ethan Carter caught the ball, did it pop out in front and hit the ground? We'll see a great view right here. Goes down to his knees to catch it. Looks like his right hand is under the football. Again, a safe pass. Get a completion early in the game. Looks like he's got it secured underneath his body. Good job.
At the further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Completed catch, first down.
Carter had a 10-yard touchdown catch against Minnesota last weekend, replacing David Sutton in the starting lineup. Sutton out with an ankle injury. He has come back today. So they can go three or four deep at that position. Newby is the offset back on first down. Strong on his own read, and it was the wrong read. Right into Dean Lowry.
Defensive line right now is controlling this game for Northwestern. Dean Lowry's done a nice job. Blue collar player, does everything good, nothing great, but he's always in the right spot. And of course, Anthony Walker, our impact player, he's got 11 tackles already in this football game, having a huge day. So right now, you got to block him up front. The offensive line for Nebraska has to create holes for this running game to go.
Mark Hankwood's defense, he laid out a few things that they needed to do well today, and they have done them all. They got off to a good start. They've handled the misdirection plays though far. They've been winning on 50-50 balls, and the secondary almost picked off again. Incomplete. Drew Smith wasn't expecting it. Intended for Pearsonell.
Pearsonell. Armstrong inaccurate on that throw, really way off. Almost threw it to the defender outside of Pearsonell. Right now, he's just not in a rhythm. Coach Riley talked about it, Paul, when he talked to him about being out of rhythm. Well, not only is the offense out of rhythm, the quarterback who leads the show in the passing game, running game, has to get himself confident in this group.
Third and 13, they need the 47-yard line. Good protection. Armstrong has all day. He finds Westerkamp inside the 40. And a first down for the Huskers.
They went in doubt. Go back to Old Faithful, right? Westerkamp again running that corner route in the hole, and it's a zone defense. You see the space open up. Great protection right here for Armstrong. He's able to set his feet, throw it in, and drop it in that hole there. Westerkamp in the right spots, found a nice opening right there for this offense. Move the chains. That's a big play they needed on a third and long situation.
These two have hooked up for their two longest plays of the day on third and long. Westerkamp now four catches, 75 yards, and Newby. Boy, Dean Lowry is making a name for himself up front today for Northwestern. In on another stop.
Right now they can't block him. And he's a force, strong, big guy. Put him on the right side here. He just does a great job coming off. Number 94 right here. He's got his hand on the ground. And it's all about, can you beat one-on-one matchup? You see the strength. They try to double team. He tosses the tackle.
Wow.
Inside. That's Stirrup.
Zach Stirrup.
Oh, that's an unbelievable job of just strength and power at the point of attack.
The second 11 has time. Going deep. Has a man out down. It's incomplete. Through the hands of Brandon Riley. Armstrong can't believe it, and neither could the crowd of nearly 90,000.
They set him up right there for a big play. You've seen that corner route to Western camp. You see him go dip down inside. Then Brandon Riley comes on top. And when that cornerback comes down to cover Western camp, he comes wide open, throws it right in the breadbasket, isn't able to make the catch. And again. When he finally makes that throw and has a perfect pass, Brandon Riley, who's been a sure-handed receiver for this team, with the big drop.
We've seen both sides unable to hang on to a sure 6 points now today. Off of play action. Here comes Lowry again. Armstrong able to scramble. Caught by Lowry inside the 35. Trying to get down to the 30-yard line. That'll be short of the marker.
Anthony Beck, the sure-handed tight end. I know you don't want to hear any excuses, but for Brandon Riley, the sun right in his eyes. I'm looking directly where that pass came from Tommy Armstrong. I knew you would have caught it, but he didn't.
Yeah, you're right. I don't want to hear excuses about the sun. Again, you got to track the ball. It's always tough for a receiver. Yeah, I mean, listen, the sun's is shining that way, but at the end of the day, you got to be able to find yourself a location in the football to make that play.
Got a flag down after that play was run.
Sideline interference, 15-yard penalty, Northwestern. Half the distance to the goal, automatic, first down. Clock operator, please reset the game clock to 11:20. 11:20, thank you.
Matt Fitzgerald wondering who did he say, that guy right there, is he with us or not? Is he a Northwestern guy on the sideline? Fitzgerald wants an answer from the line judge there. Because this is a 15-yarder and a first down. And Fitzgerald wonders who the guy was that was interfering. First and 10, Nebraska. Trying to cash in on a break here. Armstrong again with good protection. To the end zone he goes, incomplete as he overthrows Morgan.
I'm only about 5 yards from Pat Fitzgerald. He gave the umpire a earful right now. He said it wasn't our sideline. It's right over here, pointing to the fans who are located right next to him. He's still telling them right here.
You can watch the bottom of your screen. Quite sure where the interference takes place. Not too happy about it.
There's that spot where the bench runs out and it turns into fans and photographers and other folks down there. Into the backfield, Drew Smith got to Imani Cross.
The 32 Imani Cross will walk here. 55 Drew Smith. Brings up third down.
The result here, a big stop on that play for a Northwestern. Let's go back.
Yeah, right there on the bottom of your screen. Watch, see the coach and the referee.
That is
right,
yep,
there.
That's a Northwestern.
Gets him out of the way on the white. He's trying to find back into the crowd there. Doesn't want to get in trouble, but you know what? It wasn't one of their Nebraska ball guys. It was a Northwestern coach that stepped out on the line.
Terrific job there by the camera guys to get that. Armstrong. The pass caught down around the 5-yard line. Lane Hovey. And it's first and goal, Huskers.
Just rolling in receivers right now. It's all about ball placement. Runs a slant, comfortable in the pocket. Great job of catching the ball when you're defending. You have a defensive back on your back trying to pull it away. McShepard with tight coverage, but a good job on catching that football.
In the eye with Newby behind Janovich. Newby to the four. The surge may have gotten close to the three. Jordan Thompson leading the way defensively for Northwestern.
Get close down inside this 5-yard line. Start thinking about tight ends, big body guys, getting Armstrong out of the pocket to the wide side of the field. A lot of open areas. If the pass isn't there, the quarterback can run it in. See all that green grass. Top of the screen.
Second goal looking right. Westerkamp gets turned around, incomplete, diving out of bounds. Keith Atkins had the coverage.
Not quite on the same page. Westerkamp going in. Armstrong looking to go out. Coach makes a great adjustment there. Pulling it with one hand again. Got to be sharp. In the red zone, especially inside the five, you can't have mistakes Talk about all the new verbiage and the schemes of this offense. You have to be sharp in the red zone.
Third and goal. Westerkamp, Pearson, L go to the right. Armstrong, options left, keeps coming back and scores. Touchdown, Tommy Armstrong, his third TD run of the season. And he's got Nebraska back on top.
Really, that's all Tommy Armstrong there. Great awareness, just watching the flow of the defense. He just finds the end zone on a weak side option play, dangerous with his legs. Forget about him in the running game. Tremendous job on that drive to cap it off.
4 yard run to finish it. They go 15 plays, 75 yards over 6 minutes. Taken off the clock. And they are back on top, 19-7. Armstrong able to keep the drive alive.
Coach Fitzgerald not happy about that 15-yard penalty. But when they get down in the red zone, Nebraska needs to finish with the touchdown. Armstrong does a nice job.
Back here in Lincoln, Nebraska, and the Cornhuskers have taken the lead over Northwestern, 8:59 to go here in the third. Both teams pretty much needing to win to keep their hopes alive in the Big Ten West. They're already a couple games behind Iowa. Hawkeyes are sitting on a bye this week. And the return for Miles Schuler gets out across the 35 to about the 39-yard line. It's a big first half, Anthony, for the quarterback, Clayton Thorson, on the ground.
Well, you know, they had a spy there, but they weren't able to tackle, misjudging his speed. Two big runs early on. Really the two biggest plays in this game for Northwestern. They haven't done anything. And here, right before the half, Gary right there to make the tackles. And he makes a nice run to the outside, gets a stiff arm. It's been the difference in this game for them offensively. Outside of those two plays, Beth, Northwestern has done nothing today.
Look at that, just 11 total yards on their other 20 plays. We have hardly seen Justin Jackson at all, just 4 carries, 4 rushes. And this, the pass caught by the super back Garrett Dickerson. Gain of 14 and a first down. They only had 22 plays in the first half, only 3 first downs that entire first half. And yet they had the lead. Got some help by the big pick six from the defense and Nick Van Hoos. Thorson gets rid of it, but had to throw it away. Well, for Justin Jackson, averaging just under 100 yards per game, but most of that came in their 5-0 start. It's been ineffective in their last 2 losses to Iowa and Michigan.
Well, they're going against one of the top defenses against the rush. And inside, number 7, we talked about Malik Collins, are really closing up those holes. Not really giving him the ability to get anything sprung right now. And because of the quarterback's mobility and the lack of passes, they've been able to run and the passing game has been shut down.
Fake goes to Jackson and the pass out on the flank to Ryan Roberts for a short gain down to Paul.
Beth, I spoke to Justin Jackson this week. He was frustrated that he did not get the ball in those 2 losses. Only 32 carries combined. Doesn't blame the coaches. He said, we fell behind. We had to abandon the run, but I want the ball.
Well, there's other ways you can get the ball, too. Screen passes in the passing game. You just got to find ways to get your best offensive player touches.
3rd and 6. Jackson comes up with a nice block inside. Thorson going to run for it, and he's got it. Stepping out of bounds at the 30. Good protection that time by Jackson to buy a little more time. And it's a 15-yard run. Thorson now up over 120 yards rushing.
And he gets outside of the pocket. Watch number 3, newbie, gets tripped there by Justin Jackson on accident. Has the angle to make the tackle, falls down. Huge play for Thorson.
First down. Looking for Miles Schuler.
Number 5, Miles Schuler.
6 for 14 now on the day, just 35 yards passing. You talk about how good this run defense is for Nebraska, but Northwestern was hoping to take advantage in the air against the worst pass defense in the country statistically. Hasn't happened.
And Forsey really hasn't been an accurate quarterback the last couple weeks, but again, short passing game, his ability to run, something else that Nebraska has to worry about.
Second down, Thorson has a man inside the 10-yard line, and it's caught at the 8 by Mike McHugh. And it's first and goal, Northwestern, 22 yards on this play.
So it just runs a corner out away from kind of perfectly blown ball. I mean, you want to talk about a big-time throw for a young man. Thorson steps in the pocket, drills it into the outside, and only his player can catch it. I'll tell you what, it's a spectacular drive right now for this young man.
To answer the Nebraska touchdown with one of their own.
And they don't have numbers in the box.
Down to two. This is Jackson trying to get to the edge. Inside the 5, diving down close to the 1 yard line.
Outside, Nebraska stacked the box up so they couldn't get outside. They had some receivers blocking. Gets closer right now on the second down and goal.
Third leading rusher in the league and trying to get it cranked up again. And he is in there as a Wildcat. The direct snap to Jackson. Looking for a seam up the middle. Close to the goal line, and he's in. Touchdown, Northwestern. Got through a tackle of Josh Bandera and fought his way in from 2 yards out.
Great patience by Jackson on this. Just letting the play develop. Gets a blocker outside. It's just the effort. The question is, does it need
it? It's going to come back.
Before the ball crosses the lane there, and I think it, you're right. So right there is elbow hits. Clearly the ball is behind the end zone. It's going to be third and less than one here. Look at this.
Can't imagine this one would take very long.
And again, when Jackson's in that Wildcat, not probably going to see too many passes, especially down here. Immediately runs. He did it earlier in the game when they got down in the red zone before. It was another run, so.
And they don't have the fullbacks here, Anthony. They have that hybrid that they use, the super back, a guy like Dan Vitale and Garrett Dickerson. They go about 6'3", 235. Can line up as a receiver or tight end or put him in the backfield to try and get this 1 yard that it looks like they will need after the review.
Should be pretty quick. Yeah, good video shot of it on our end.
...23-19, Nebraska scoring on its first possession of the second half.
Again, if they do overturn this and bring it back, which we think they will, it'll be short, less than a yard. Third down, you know, to me, we talked about it earlier, Justin Jackson, big back, offensive lineman. You know, this is a ground and pound team. You got to put it on the backs of your offense.
At the further review, the runner's knee was down prior to him breaking the plane of the goal line. The ball will be placed at the half-yard line. It'll be third down and goal.
If it's not Justin Jackson, it could be the quarterback just reaching over, 6'4", 220 pounds. Two options for sure that they have. This offensive line has to make a statement on a road. It'll be loud down there in that end zone. They got to get some push on this defensive line.
Malik Collins keeping him out.
Your best defensive lineman is right over the center, and he basically locks, strong arms him out. Watch seven right over the center, just shoot through his legs, and that really gets everything disconjointed in the run game. Knocks over Dan Vitale, number 40, the lead blocker. Forster tries to bounce it outside. Huge stop for this Nebraska defense.
They will force the field goal attempt here on fourth down. He's been good from 28. Jack Mitchell now from 18. Nailed it. Northwestern goes back on top, 20-19. Cats thought they had seven. They've got to settle for three. Well, if you've been following the Huskers this year, you've come to expect some close games, and another one shaping up here in Lincoln, 20-19. Each side getting points up on the board with their first possessions of this second half. Now Northwestern set to boot it away. Jordan Stevenson is back deep. The ball will fall off the tee. We'll remind you tonight at 8 o'clock on ABC, Saturday Night Football, Ohio State at Rutgers. Saturday Night Football presented by Walmart. Zeke Elliott and the Buckeyes, 20 wins in a row, looking to add to it. 8 o'clock on ABC, also streaming live on Watch ESPN. They are projected number one for the playoff as well. The first actual poll from the committee will be out a week from Tuesday. As Stevenson returns it out to the 24. How about Ezekiel Elliott and the job he's been doing over the last couple of seasons? The most yards from scrimmage in FBS, tearing it up at the end of last season to guide them to the national championship.
He's been the one constant on offense that you can kind of go back to Old Faithful with. He's been there every single week, and I think you're going to see more of his success with JT Barrett getting the start with that read pass option now where he really rides them. Both of those guys could have a big game rushing against Rutgers.
Scarlet Knights had that nice comeback win last week, but they have never beaten the number one ranked team in the country, 0 for 4 all time. As they get set to host the Buckeyes tonight. Demarne Pearson-Ell with the catch out across the 35 and a first down. As Armstrong tries to settle things down a little bit here in the second half, he led them down the field for a touchdown the first time they had it.
He did, came out in the second half more accurate, dropping some balls into Westerkamp, and again spread the ball around, keep this Northwestern defense on their heels.
Newby out of the backfield to about the 43. Looked like that may develop into something a little bigger, but Drew Smith able to sneak in there to stop it.
Been stymie at times. They're in the right spots. They're well coached by defensive coordinator Mike Hankwitz. They're tough players across the board, and they know where to be. And I think that's the biggest thing when you watch this football team. And of course, their head coach, being Pat Fitzgerald, obviously helps. One of the all-time great linebackers in the Northwestern history.
Looks like he's got the first down. Talked about Keith Watkins getting the start for Matthew Harris in the secondary. Last week was the first time that happened. In their first six games, the defensive unit had the same starting 11 every single week out. So that continuity has helped them as well on this side of the ball.
And next man up, you know, Watkins came in his first start, 9 tackles in that game. You know, that's what you want. Guys can step in and replace star players.
Armstrong so far in the second half, 5 for 10, 75 yards through the air, and he's looking for more. Cross with the catch and then slam to the turf back at the line of scrimmage by Jalen Prater. The forward progress will get him out to midfield.
Prater, first-year starter, led the team in tackles last week with 11. Playing well. They like what he's done on the field. Again, youth at the linebacker position. Walker having a nice game in the inside, in the middle. solid crew, not a lot of speed with Prater, but gets the job done in the right spot, has good football instincts.
And these two teams have gotten used to playing some tight matchups together. It's happened in three of the last four seasons, as a matter of fact, decided by a field goal or less. Looking for the deep ball, incomplete, just overthrown to Turner on a little hitch and go.
Redesign play, get himself rolled out to the left. And again, they want to force him to the left, but when it's pre-designed, they had the receiver down the sidelines. The problem is Turner stopped running there for a second. That ball would have been right in his hands. Again, you've got to be ready. They've been throwing that out route to Westerkamp all game long. You can't fall asleep when you're out on the outside. Right there, a missed opportunity for Nebraska.
Both teams have had a sure touchdown lost, and that could have been another one right there for Nebraska. They'll go back to it. This time with Demone Pearson-El at the other end, and penalty flags are down on Marcus McShepard. Igwebuke and tell him something.
Pass interference. Defense. Number 17. 15-yard penalty. Automatic. First down.
It's always tough for a cornerback when the ball's underthrown to find the football. And Pearson-El has two, three steps on him, but you can't run through the receiver. And when he stops to come back for the underthrown football, it's almost a guarantee every single time that corner's going to be running through the wide receiver. Tough position to be put in, but again, advantage Nebraska.
And a first down at the 35-yard line for the Cornhuskers. Back to the turf. Cross. Riggins is really inside the 30. Crosses the senior out of Angel, Georgia. Gives you the good hard yards. That's what Danny Langsdorf told us about Cross. Good hard yards right there.
240 pounds. He's a downhill runner. He's not going to do much as far as in space or catching the football. He's got 23 touchdowns over his career, so he sniffed the end zone quite a bit. He's a changeup back, but first down yards crucial so far this third quarter. Done a nice job, Nebraska, getting those short second downs where you can run or pass in this situation.
Is his way inside the 25. Looks like another first down for Nebraska. A 5-yard gain to move the chains. Week 7 of Monday Night Football coming your way on ESPN. Arizona and Baltimore. It's the Ravens and Cardinals coverage beginning with Monday Night Countdown at 6. Also streaming live on ESPN.
What has happened to the Ravens? They've been brutal this year.
This is, I believe, the fourth time they're heading out west. They've already lost to Oakland and San Francisco and Denver, and now back out to Arizona. And a drop from Pearson-El. It's contagious today for both sides.
Well, we've seen a little bit of both. We've seen some poor throws by Armstrong in this game. We've seen him come back in this football game and make some really nice throws. Again, he tracks it to his hands. Just got to squeeze down on it. Armstrong's had some chances in this game to make huge plays. Receivers have let him down with a few drops right there. Four drops in this football game, and they all would have been big plays.
Look at the difference in the plays run. 70 for Nebraska, just 31 for Northwestern, and they've got the lead. For the moment, Armstrong on the move. They set up the receiver screen. Snuffed out by the DBs. Watkins was there.
That play on the pass, two plays ago on first down, you lose that yardage. You don't get a big gain on second down. Now you're in third long again. Armstrong's done well in this area right now. He's got to make a big play. If it's not there, don't compound it. Make a play with your legs if they're covered up.
Over 50% today on third down conversions. Again. Fadi Adenabo was after him. Armstrong could not find anybody downfield, and there's an injured player over on the Nebraska sideline. It's one of the Northwestern Wildcats. A loss of 10 on the play. It's fourth down and 19. And the first sack of the day for Northwestern.
I think that's Prater. Tough to tell. Great getting to the football by that on that play by the defense. And
I think one of the guys that was in pursuit, Lowry, and number seven is Chapman, Max Chapman. They have gotten the wind knocked out of him there, one of their backup D linemen.
He did.
You mentioned Jalen Prater, Anthony. He had just gone out two plays later, got nicked up. Two plays earlier. That was Tommy Armstrong trying to go with this one.
And everyone's covered up. On defense, good job by this Northwestern defense on the back end, and again, doesn't force a throw, takes the sack. Fortunately, you want to try to get back to the line of scrimmage and not lose yards. She loses a few on this field goal opportunity, so long kick right now.
Drew Brown has a 43-yarder today, and now a 48-yarder to get the lead back. His long on the season, a 50-yarder. To assist Nebraska trying to get the lead back when we return for the fourth. So many good memories over the years for the Huskers here at Memorial Stadium. They've actually dropped a couple of nail biters at home this year, and starting to shape up like another close one here. Drew Brown on the season, 6 of 8 from over 40 yards. He's trying for 48 right now. For the lead, trying to sneak it inside the right upright, he does. His second field goal over 40 yards today, and it's a 22-20 lead for Nebraska. Nebraska has dominated with their plays run, their time of possession, but still tight on the scoreboard. They are back on top. The story here in Lincoln, well, if you looked at those bottom three numbers in particular, you're thinking blowout. They've had the ball for over a half an hour, have held Northwestern to just 6 first downs, and yet the scoreboard tells a little different story. It is just a 2-point game. Nebraska in front after that field goal by Drew Brown. And as we start out the fourth quarter, Northwestern with the ball, but first an update from Chris.
All right, Beth, well, it wasn't looking good early for unbeaten Houston. They were down 10-7, but oh boy, they really turned things up. DeMarcus Ayers, 67 yards. It's now 52-10 over on ESPN News. They're going to join Temple and Memphis at 7-0 in the American. Yeah.
Chris, that would be an American revolution right there with those three undefeated. Thank you very much, Anthony. Especially Temple, Philly, Independence Hall. They're all unbeaten. First time they could possibly meet, by the way, Memphis at Houston on November 14th. Temple's got that big game against Notre Dame next Saturday. And on first down, Thorson's pass is dropped again by Christian Jones.
Yeah, right now, his mentals aren't quite there, and he's going through a rough patch. Last couple games, drop balls today, drops the touchdown pass where they eventually got a field goal with. But those opportunities there, he's a senior. He's going through those ups and downs. He's got to focus on catching the football, and he's right now getting his confidence with Coach Fitzgerald on the sideline.
That's trying to keep him involved in this game. They may need him here in the fourth quarter. Second and 10, can they get Jackson revved up? Not on this particular occasion. Anthony, when it's mental like that, when it's in your head as a receiver, as a tight end, what do you have? I mean, you need that one catch to get you going again, right?
Well, as a coaching staff, offensive coordinator, you said he's an important part. You got to try to get a quick one to him. Just get his hands around the football so he can catch it. But again, they've given him a couple chances. Still hasn't been able to do it. And you see him on the sideline. He's obviously mentally out of it. You got to take him out of the football game right now and count on some other players.
Big one was a drop in the end zone. He did not control the ball through the catch and what would have been a touchdown for Northwestern. And now on third down, five men coming in the black jerseys, forcing another good stiff arm, and then the pass incomplete. And it's fourth down.
Gangrish does a nice job. He feels the pursuit. He's rushing up the field, but he gets off the last second, and he's able to put pressure on Forson when he gets to the outside. Watch this, Ali disengages and tracks him. Again, Forson, got to watch yourself when you're throwing it back against the grain, a young quarterback. You're fortunate on that play.
Pearson L will stay away from it. It will take a Northwestern bounce or two or three. And trickle down inside the 20, 56 yards on the punt. Heading down the home stretch in what appears to be another close one between the Cats and the Huskers here in Lincoln. It's been a good series in recent years. You go back to 2011, Northwestern stunned 10th-ranked Nebraska behind Kane Coulter's 3 second-half touchdowns. A year later, Nebraska rallied from down 12 in the fourth quarter to win it by a point. 2013 was the Westerkamp Hail Mary from Ron Kellogg. And then last year, the only one that was a rout as Amir Abdullah ran wild for 4 touchdowns. And down the stretch again in a 2-point game that, Anthony, very easily could be a little bit more breathing room for Nebraska.
Some opportunities in this football game where when you look at the time of possession, you look at the number of plays between these two teams, that they could have actually lengthened and did some more things on the scoreboard. But unfortunately right now with the 2-point lead, it's close just like every game's been for them this season.
Time of possession, they've had it over 32 minutes. They have run now with this play 40 more plays than Northwestern has today. Here's some of the things we were talking about. Woulda, coulda, shoulda.
Wide open corner route, Brandon Riley. Perfectly thrown ball, not able to pull it in. Missed opportunity. They've been hitting Westerkamp all day. Finally, they get the deep route. And Turner slows his route down on a ball that he lays up and then Pearson L on a first down, drops the ball, puts him in a long situation on third down, weren't able to convert and only get a field goal in that situation.
Third down conversion here, Armstrong, incomplete. And they will have to punt it back to Northwestern, may have been deflected at the line.
Watch the football, trap it out of his hands, hits the helmet.
Chapman, who was the guy that went out with the injury the previous possession, he's back out there. But now it's 4th and 3. Shuler standing back at his own 25-yard line. By Fultz, it's deep. Shuler all the way back near his 10-yard line. Flags are down behind the return. Shuler gets it out to the 40-yard line. And now another flag after the end of the play on a block that kept on going out towards midfield. And Pat Fitzgerald asking Marcus McShepard, why would you do that?
It's a selfish play. You can't have it. Compounds, obviously, you have the hold, and they bring it back, and now you get that personal foul. Not real smart on special teams. You know Coach Fitzpatrick heavily involved in special teams for this Northwestern team.
Fitzgerald now in his 10th season at his alma mater. He's the all-time winningest coach there. Played for a couple of Big Ten championship teams back in the mid-90s.
During the return, legal block in the back. Number 17, half the distance to the goal. Also, after the play, unsportsmanlike conduct. on Nebraska, number 29, his first. First and 10 for Northwestern. TV timeout.
Northwestern hurting itself with the penalty there. They'll have it deep in their own territory when we return.
You see the block in the back right there by Northwestern. Again, you can't do that. You come across and keep your eyes on the 50-yard line right here. After the runner had gone out of bounds, 29 for Nebraska hits him after the play's over, and that's going to draw the personal foul flag.
So the correction there, we thought it was going to be on Northwestern both times, but the second foul is on Nebraska, the personal foul. So that will help out the Wildcats and get them the ball back out across the 25. Forsen looking to go deep. Incomplete. Overthrows his target, Miles Shuler. Second and 10.
I'll tell you what, the offensive line for Northwestern in these massive situations has done a nice job. Left guard, Mogus, Park the center, Frazier the right guard, getting that protection, giving the young man some time. That's important when you have a redshirt freshman quarterback.
Just 56 yards passing today for Northwestern. Against the defense that gives up nearly 350 a game. Forsen off the back foot, and Wisely hurls that one out of play. Jack Gangwish was bearing down on him. And now it's third down and 10.
Right now, Nebraska's got to feel pretty good about their defense in this third and long situation. Again, they've gotten pressure up the middle. They forced Forsen to the outside several times, just like you saw Gangwish make a big play. And force an errant throw. They're going to lock it up across man-to-man, across all the wide receivers, trying to get to the quarterback.
Wilson throws it across the middle, and it's caught for the first down. Austin Carr with the catch out across the 35 and a gain of 14.
Austin Carr is a sure-handed inside receiver who they dearly missed last week against Iowa. Huge catch for him.
Pull it down, the play action, and then the quick throw. Thorson out to Vitaly. Falls on it, but I think they're going to rule that an incomplete pass. Second down. This week about reestablishing the run. Thorson has over 100 yards rushing, but Jackson has been quiet. 7 carries for 10 yards. And he will come out.
Yeah, Nebraska's corners are challenging the wide receivers on the outside.
Throw across the middle. That's a completion to Vitaly.
Pass complete to number 14, Dan Vitaly.
Third down and 5. That's made by the Northwestern will fight for what would only be its 8th first down of the day if they can get it.
Now, Christian Jones, on top of the screen, on the line of scrimmage, had a rough day. See if they continue confidence with him and give him another shot.
Huskers. Bringing the rush, Thorson tipped up in the air by Vault, and it's caught. First down across midfield. Nine yards on that pass play.
Concentration. Well, obviously, Thorson fires that ball in. Do we have possession? And now they're going to go check that out.
The ruling on the field was a completed catch. The previous play is under further review.
Just 2 third down conversions all day, and now they've got 2 on this drive. If this one stands, only needs the 1 foot. Yeah.
Looks like the question is it in his right hand? Does it have control before he pulls it in? It looks like he does.
They would need evidence that he did not in order to reverse it. Right now, it stands as a catch.
At the further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. First down.
That's quick.
nice job. Now the youngster, the sophomore, Gaithersburg, Maryland.
Justin Jackson. 45-yard line.
More football coming your way tonight. College football primetime presented by Hilton. Texas A&M visiting Ole Miss. Then at 10:30 out to Palo Alto for Stanford and Washington. Both games are on ESPN and also streaming live on the Watch ESPN app. Under 11 minutes to go. Both defenses have scored today, including a pick six for Northwestern. They have run 35 fewer plays, have had the ball about a third of the time. But Nebraska has had it, and they are on the move here with another first down. More third down conversions, Anthony, on this drive than they had the previous three quarters combined.
Nice job there, that a weak side play. All the defensive backs and defensive players are heavy on the right. They come back and get that first down conversion with Jackson's legs.
Tire the motion there. It's coming off the edge. Dorsey with time. Vitale with the catch on the run. 10-5. Lunging for the goal line. Touchdown, Northwestern.
Pass complete to number 40, David Collins.
37 yards, Thorson to Vitale, the super back. And look at this effort.
Good job. Throw, catch, getting the one-on-one. Coverage with the linebacker, Young. Only a freshman, true freshman. Get a favorable matchup with your super back, senior Dan Vitale.
Longest pass play of the game. For Vitale, his third touchdown catch of the season, making his 42nd career start today for the senior out of Wheaton, Illinois.
Again, controlling his body, his hands allowed to hit, but does his elbow hit before the ball crosses? Again, you don't have the angle there to see where the ball is when his elbow does hit the ground. Look at that. What an athletic ability there just to kind of keep his body off the ground. I don't know if we're going to have enough here, Beth, to change this call. But.
Touchdown.
And it is a ruling that will stand. Touchdown, Northwestern. Our fourth lead change of this second half. Back and forth we go. PAT for Jack Mitchell to try and make it a 5-point lead. And it's good. 37 yards, Thorson to Vitale to cap off the drive. Some critical third down conversions to keep it going.
And you gotta find your Superman player, hit your super back. Danny Vitale with great athleticism to get across the end zone. Thorson is a happy camper.
More passing yardage on that drive, 66 yards for Northwestern than they had the entire game previous. And they are back on top, 27-22. Dan Vitale with the touchdown reception. And the kick through the end zone for the touchback. Time now for the latest dish, brought to you by Dish Network. And it's been a theme that the Huskers want to try and change now. They've been all right through three quarters this year, outscored in the fourth. And in overtime, we've already talked about the four heartbreaking losses on the opponent's final possession in the final seconds in overtime. They've figured out all kinds of different ways to get done in. And now a chance for Tommy Armstrong here in the fourth to move this offense back down the field. Pressure coming, Bruce Smith. Armstrong able to get away from it. Throws downfield. green grass in front of him.
This is disappointing right now because the opportunities that have been left on the field, Armstrong does a tremendous job of getting away from a sack, puts the ball right in the hands of Allen, and he turns before he catches it.
Nobody back there, Anthony.
You got to catch the football, and you got to help this young man. This quarterback has been doing a great job. That's five drops in this game right in the hands of the wide receivers.
Second and 10. And that one's batted down. Guess who? Dean Lowry.
Beth, the Huskers have ran close to double the amount of plays compared to Northwestern. Pat Fitzgerald said this week they ran out of gas against Iowa and couldn't get off the field. I'll tell you what, I've been monitoring this unit after the three and out, their last possession, and the long stretched out drive by their offense. This group is rested and ready to go.
They're going to need a little extra juice. The defense, Paul, has been out there nearly 35 minutes today. Bringing the heat on the quarterback, Armstrong. Tries to get loose, and down he goes in the grasp of Dean Lowry again.
Denabu came off the edge. Multiple players coming through. Again, good coverage in the back end. Chapman, number one. There's Adenapu getting inside. Chapman holding on. Got to wrap up this year. Armstrong's gotten away from multiple defenders. And Mr. Lowry cleans it up at the end. The senior, the leader on this defense for Northwestern.
Big stop there. And as Paul referenced, the defense jacked up and trying to get off the field with the three and out. And the kick. Sure. A couple of shimmy shakes. Past the first wave across midfield. And now it bounds around the 40-yard line. 27-22 Northwestern with the lead, 8:42 to go. And amazing when you look at the stat sheet, Anthony, everything favoring Nebraska in terms of times of possession, the number of plays they run, but it's been very opportunistic for Northwestern picking and choosing their moments.
Well, Northwestern has done a nice job just continuing to play football. Talked about a couple tough games last week against Iowa coming on the road, but to me the big story is Nebraska's opportunities or missed opportunities in this football game. Drop footballs, Armstrong's done a nice job of throwing the ball and making passes. They just have not completed, and Northwestern is taking advantage right now.
Thorson feeling confident to Justin Jackson. First down. Stiff arms the defender. Knocked out of bounds at the 14-yard line. 26 yards on the gain, and now the yardage coming in chunks.
Well, we talked about it. If you can't get them the ball in the run game, find them in the passing game. Right there, crossing route, they got a mismatch against a linebacker. Banderas across the middle, an easy throw and catch. And again, accuracy, catchable football, moving the chains down the field.
Action on first down. Dickerson, the pass was behind him, incomplete at the 10. Northwestern, they had 1 yard passing in the first quarter, and now look at the progression, 93 yards in the air here in the fourth.
Look at that. Think about what this Nebraska defense has done, but fourth quarter's been their Achilles heel, especially in the passing game, Beth. They've severely let some big yardage up in each of the fourth quarters of their games this year, especially in the losses.
Second and 10, Jackson. Nice cutback, finds the hole down to the 10. Banderas took him down high, and it will be third down. The first down marker is at the 3.
Nebraska's got to come up with a big stop here. They've done it multiple times on third down throughout this game. Really put in a situation where their offense isn't converting, and they got to make some stops. It's Northwestern team right now. Hasn't really had a lot of steam or good play in the red zone. This is one of their few opportunities where they can take advantage of this right now.
Pressure coming from the black shirts. Thorson's throw is away, incomplete. and it's fourth down. And even if you give up the field goal here, you're still a touchdown and a two-point conversion away from tying it up. Still with 7.5 minutes to go.
What do you do when you have a redshirt freshman quarterback on defense? You make him speed the process up. And Gary, the 25, strong safety, comes off, forces him to throw the ball early to Vault, who is waiting to come out of his route. Again, good job, good dial up by defensive coordinator Mark Banker for Nebraska.
Mitchell looking to go 3 for 3. This one a 27-yard attempt. And it's good. 30-22, Northwestern up 8, 7.5 to play here in Lincoln. Well, the Husker heartbreak this year has looked like this. The 4 losses late in games, the Hail Mary against BYU, that was here in Lincoln. Then after rallying in the fourth quarter to force OT, Miami beats Nebraska with a field goal. This was a critical conversion that really could have sealed it, that Nebraska wasn't able to get through, and West Lund a couple of fourth quarter TD passes for Illinois, and this the game-winning field goal for Wisconsin, also here in Lincoln. Only the second FBS team in the last decade to lose 4 games when the opponent won in the final 10 seconds or in overtime. Will they have an opportunity to make a play of their own to win a ball game late? They need a touchdown and a two-point conversion just to tie it up, but there's still plenty of time, 7.5 minutes to go.
Well, I think Tommy Armstrong's done a nice job so far in this football game. One, continuing plays. There's been some times where it's broken down. He's been able to roll out. They've dropped some balls. The one guy I haven't heard call his name out too much in the second half is Jordan Westerkamp, number one. That's his go-to receiver. Let's see if he tries to hit number one in a few of these plays, get that rhythm back at the wide receiver position.
4 catches, 75 yards, but just one of those in the second half. Strong, keeping it all the way. That's a nice block from Carter, his tight end, to spring him loose out to the 40 and a first down.
Weak side option, quarterback redesigned run. Like you said, the big tight end, Stephen Carter, getting that edge blocked up, and huge game, big first down run. Again, keeping it in the hands of Armstrong, who's doing playing a good game today.
...237 yards passing with a touchdown and a pick 6 for Armstrong. He's also rushed it 11 times for 10 yards. All day to throw this, and that is Westerkamp with the sliding catch around the 44-yard line and a first down, 17 yards on that toss.
I know this guy's going to catch the football, and I think right now he's a target that they can take advantage of. Pulling him out of the game right now, and he's wanting to get back in. But I'm sure this break isn't going to be long.
He turned it 9 times with 5 catches. Shade under 100 yards on the day for Jordan. Damani Cross is the eye back. Westerkamp is back out there.
8 of 4 yards, second down and 6 at the 40-yard line.
Just got to keep your focus as an offensive player for Nebraska. You're moving the ball up and down the field. Got to finish drives, down by 8 right now. Put some things together. Amazing how a right-handed quarterback can roll to the left and throw that ball in. Watch the top of the screen. Look at 94. You see the left tackle pulling on the shoulder pad. It's right in front of the referee. I'm surprised he didn't pull a flag on it.
That's Alex Lewis. Now it's 3rd down and 6. Oh, Nick Van Hoos got his hand up. Intended for Turner.
That's a tough completion. Tight coverage by Van Hoos here on the receiver. All the way across the field, and really it's just a good play. No separation by Turner at the wide receiver position. And you know, to me, when you set back the quarterback, maybe get some opportunities to run in some of those lanes. Now they have a big fourth down pressure on this offense. Stood in the pocket there, took a low blow on a defensive lineman, falling down to his legs. Gibson coming on the outside rush, and he just drops a dime. And I'll tell you what, Brandon Riley redeeming himself on this one right here, tracking the football into his hands off a very good corner. And Van Hoos right here tracks the football, brings it into his body, holds on. Huge conversion for that team.
On first and goal, Terrell Newby. Stuffed at the line, thrown down by Gibson.
Number 34, Terrell Newby, the launcher.
Second and goal.
You see him get rolled up and gets his foot caught underneath, obviously rolled up on his ankle a little bit. He is a competitor, he's a tough player.
Does that take away any options that you might want to use with him on a rollout?
Well, unfortunately, you're right. That obviously will affect his running ability, but I think right now you got to do what you got to do, and he's a tough kid. And got to utilize it. It's worked today. Why not?
There he is on the move. Strong. Even on the bone ankle. Touchdown, Nebraska. With 4:23 to go, do they send out the PAT kicker? You got guys coming in to go for two.
Got to go for two on this one. Heck of a job. I think he answered your question about his ankle. Guys just takes that big hit, gets it around the outside, still limping a little bit, but right now he's in this game. The adrenaline is pulling that pain away from him. As a football player, you're out there and your team needs you. You're not thinking about injuries.
The 2-point conversion for the tie with 4:23 to go.
Make a sprint out to the right.
Northwestern hangs on to the lead, up two with 4:23 to go. Intended for Stanley Morgan.
They definitely tried to get Armstrong out of the pocket, had the ball in the far hash. Here's the long pass that got him down there. This is on fourth down, folks. Watch him stand in the pocket. Defensive end falls back on his legs, throws the ball up. Brandon Riley, number 87, comes back. Here's the touchdown. Watch his block right there. Newby, great job with the cut. And then the 2-point conversion. They put it on the left hash. Armstrong comes back across, tries to get it in to Morgan, number 8, the wide receiver. Tight coverage by Nebraska. They don't convert, and right now, Beth, down two, just over 4 minutes left.
Marcus McShepard is the guy that broke up the pass. Down to the wire we go yet again. Three of their last four meetings decided by 3 points or less, including a Hail Mary here in Nebraska's favor a couple years ago. You've talked all week, if you're Northwestern, about being a better ball control offense. That hasn't been the case today, but you've got an opportunity for Pat Fitzgerald's club to try and work this clock. Nebraska has its full complement of 3 timeouts remaining. First and 10 from just outside the 25 on the return from Shuler.
I think right now for Northwestern, Nebraska's defense is going to be up in the face of these wide receivers. They're going to force them to make some plays in the running game. Justin Jackson right now He's a back in the Big Ten. He's a big, strong guy. Had a nice play out of the backfield. Thorson's made some plays with his legs today, but your offensive line has to find ways to make holes. This is running situations. You're up two. You got to get a nice drive. 4-minute drill here for this offense. Right now, this Nebraska defense and this crowd getting them hyped and excited for this series.
First down. Thorson stepping up now, tuck and run. And the awkward slide out to the 30, a gain of 5. Always have to be cognizant of where number 7, Malik Collins, is the defensive tackle for Nebraska.
Good play there. You spread out your wide receivers. You got one back in the backfield. And if you get that open hole, you give him a one-look read on a quick play. If he doesn't have it, he can make some plays with his legs. 2nd and 5. Good position for this offense to be in.
Justin Jackson, their 1,000-yard rusher from a year ago, third best rusher in the Big Ten this season. Picks up a few. It's 3rd down. After tonight's Pac-12 showdown, stick around for Sports Center at Night. Get your post-game recap with a full breakdown of the day in college football at Sports Center at Night, kicking off right after the Washington-Stanford game on ESPN and on Watch ESPN. You're up a couple, 3:27 to go. It's 3rd and 3.
Again, spread out the defense, right? Give your quarterback a quick option. If he doesn't have it, maybe he hits those lanes. He's been really beating the Nebraska defense with his legs right now. And if I'm forcing, I'm thinking, listen, check my read. If it's not there, maybe take off, be smart. Again, don't force anything in there. Worst case scenario, Beth, you punt it away, you put your defense on the field and force a Nebraska offense right now that's been clicking up the lead.
Dumps it off to his back, Jackson, and he's got the 1st down. Breaks a tackle across midfield. The cutback down to the 40. And once they reset the chains, they'll restart that clock. 28 yards on the pass play.
Nice job by Jackson. He's in a full scan in the backfield. The blitz doesn't come. And look, he's dangerous in the open field. You better wrap around. He's got great moves. Look at the quickness. He hasn't done it in the running game today, Beth, but in the passing game, he's made some big plays for this football team.
Now you got to hold on to that football and make Nebraska burn a couple of their timeouts remaining. Jackson is the offset back. He'll take it. Pat Fitzgerald talked about playing a clean game today. They were hurt by turnovers in their losses to Iowa and to Michigan. They played a clean game today. They've cut the penalties down today.
You see this play clock right here. You're going to get that way down. If you're on offense for Northwestern, you're going to take your time. Got positive yards on 1st down. You're going to make sure your personnel is right. Get the right guys in there.
They can take this all the way down close to the 2-minute mark before they snap if they want to. Jackson, big hole up the middle to the 30-yard line. And is that good enough for another 1st down? It appears to be. Jeff Mogus, Ian Park, Blake Hance, Matt Frazier, Eric Olson, those guys up front leading the way for Northwestern.
Yeah, Mogus, left guard. Watch him just seal up all the way to the 2nd level. And that was the biggest hole I think Northwestern's had in 4 weeks. I mean, that's fantastic. Look at his hole, folks.
Look at Park, too, with a push.
Our sideline reporter, Paul Carcaterra, can get up in that hole. That's how big it was. Huge play for Northwestern there. You move the chains, you get a fresh set of downs. I'll tell you what, that was big. Big play by this offensive line for Northwestern.
You force Nebraska to call for another timeout. They have just the one left, under 2 minutes to go. A win for Northwestern gets them their sixth win of the season and bowl eligible. They haven't been bowling in the last couple of seasons. Of course, that 2012 bowl win, their first since World War II. That 10-win season for Pat Fitzgerald. And why it's significant, you can't afford another slip-up if you're one of these two teams. You'd fall three games behind Iowa with only five left to play.
Again, you get an immediate timeout by Northwestern on this play. It'll be their last, and then the clock will be running against them.
Northwestern will force Nebraska's hand. They'll keep it on the ground, and then they're going to tack on some extra yardage. That is Malik Collins, who may be flagged here for the additional foul.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct. Defense, number 7. Half the distance to the goal, automatic. First down.
That's their second unsportsmanlike penalty of this half.
Yeah, you can't have it. And this is a selfish play. You got to know the situation. Finishing that block a little bit. Right there, you got to walk away, folks. I know it's a tough man's game. When you got referees right here, everybody sees it. Northwestern, the smarter team right now in that situation. Luring Collins on that flag. Nebraska not calling a timeout there. Clock is ticking. Wait for this first down play to go. Not going to have much time at all.
Timeout. Northwestern. First of the half. 30-second charge. Timeout.
26 left on the clock. Nebraska right now at 3-4 and looking at the very real possibility of dropping a third home game of the season. And for Northwestern, boy, you look at the effort from Clayton Thorson today. Those two huge runs in the first half and engineering the scoring drives through the air in the second.
Yeah, I'll tell you, it's a tale of two halves for him. He did it with his legs in the first half and his arm in the second. I think his composure as a quarterback, he's a redshirt freshman, you know, not going for the deep kill shots, checking it down to his running backs. Justin Jackson had a nice plays out of the backfield. He found the open receivers. He really used his dual threat ability today, and I think that's the one thing that if you talk to the Northwestern coaches, they wanted to see a little more done with his legs, and that set up the whole game right now for this Northwestern offense.
They want to try and shut this down and get into their bye week, and then the rest of the Northwestern schedule, Penn State, Purdue, Wisconsin, and Illinois down the stretch. Can Nebraska make a play? Force him on the rollout and he would just slide down.
Feel this one out after this timeout.
About how important this game was for both of these teams in the West Division, with Iowa out in front right now, undefeated.